Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Life. Today is 24th April. Here I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from today's current affairs and the important facts related with each question. So watch the video very carefully and try to answer the question asked at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the latest current affairs from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as Telegram groups. Also, you can find the link for the Hindi version of this video in the below given description box. The link for the Hindi current affairs is given there. Before moving forward, let's check the answer for the question asked in the last video. Which country ranked first in the Index of Cancer Preparedness 2019? The correct answer is Option D, Australia. Now, let's begin our session for today. Here comes our question number 1. Who won India's first gold medal at the Asian Wrestling Championship 2019? The correct answer is Option C, Bajrang Punia. World number 1 Bajrang Punia won India's first gold medal in the 65 kg category at the Asian Wrestling Championship 2019 in Xi'an, China. Bajrang defeated Sayatbek Okasov at Kazakhstan 12-7 in the final to bag the medal. Meanwhile, Praveen Rana settled for silver and Satyavratan Kadian won bronze in 97 kg category. Apart from these two, in the women's event, India's top wrestler Vinesh Pogat, Sakshi Malik, Pooja Danda and Divya Kakran are also in contention. Now let me share few more informations about Asian Wrestling Championship. It is organized by Asian Associated Wrestling Committee. The men's tournament began in 1979. The women's tournament was first staged in 1996. It has been held every year. 2019 Asian Championship host city is Xi'an, China. The dates are from April 23rd to 28th. Heading to our question number 2. Who is named as brand ambassador of Indo-American Arts Council? The correct answer is Option D, Vikas Khanna. Vikas Khanna, Michelin star chef, named as brand ambassador of Indo-American Arts Council, a leading cultural organization which will organize the annual New York Indian Film Festival that would showcase the chef's film The Last Color and Nawazuddin Siddiq starred photograph. The New York Indian Film Festival is North America's longest running and most prestigious Indian film festival that would be organized from May 7 to 12, 2019. The festival will showcase 30 feature length films, including 3 documentaries, 30 shorts and 19 regional films. Vikas Khanna's film The Last Color is the closing night film of the festival. Now let me share few more informations about the Indo-American Arts Council. It was founded on 1st August 1998. The founder is Arun Shivdasani Gopal Raju. It is located at New York City, New York, United States. Heading to our question number 3. Which organization joined hands with Wellingkar Institute of Management to support startups in exports? The correct answer is Option A, Federation of Indian Export Organizations. Federation of Indian Export Organizations inked an agreement with Mumbai-based PRIN, L.N. Wellingkar Institute of Management Development and Research in order to support startups engaged in the export sector. Under the Memorandum of Understanding, FIEO launched a postgraduate program in foreign trade management at Mumbai. The main aim of this industry-academia partnership is to attract new entrepreneurs in export to bridge the gap of availability of qualified skilled manpower in exim trade. The program would consist of all the general management principles, export-import procedures and international marketing concepts, and the duration of the program will be 11 months. The program will be offered in two batches. Graduates from recognized university who qualify the requirements can apply for direct admission to the course, and the first batch will begin from August of 2019. Heading to our question number 4. Mount Agung, which erupted recently, is located in Dash. The correct answer is option B, Bali, Indonesia. The active volcano of Indonesia, Mount Agung, has erupted again to a height of 2 km. Two other volcanoes popular with tourists, Mount Bromo in East Java and Mount Merapi in Yogyakarta, also continue to erupt. Now let me share a few more information about Mount Agung. Mount Agung is an active volcano in Bali of Indonesia. It dominates the surrounding area, influencing the climate, especially rainfall patterns. It began erupting in 2017. This volcano's latest eruption is ongoing as of 2019. The classification of volcanoes are: a popular way of classifying magmatic volcanoes is by their frequency of eruption, with those that erupt regularly called active, those that have erupted in historical times but are now quite called dormant or inactive, and those that have not erupted in historical times called extinct. The lifespan of a volcano can vary from months to several million years. Moving to our question number 5. Dash launched a mobile app that offers loans for salaried professionals. The correct answer is option D, Moneylogy. Moneylogy, a modern money lending platform, launched an application which offers loan to salaried professionals within 5 minutes with flexible repayment options starting from 7 days to a maximum of 90 days. It follows a 3-step process, which are application, approval and disbursement. The app requires the user to upload an identity proof, an address proof, last 3 months bank statement alongside the salary slip. The eligibility criteria to avail this benefit are minimum in-hand salary of rupees 20,000 per month and a minimum age of 23 years. It not only ensures security but also reduces chances of data misuse, backed by world-class security protocols to encrypt all the data. It has a flexible repayment process where customer can repay in one EMI if the tenure of the loan is below 30 days, and can get an option to pay in 3 easy EMIs if the loan tenure is above 30 days and up to 90 days. Heading to our question number 6. The venue of the IPL 2019 final match was shifted from Chennai to Dash. The correct answer is option A, Rajiv Gandhi International Cricket Stadium, Hyderabad. The final of the Indian Premier League, scheduled for May 12, has been moved to the Rajiv Gandhi International Stadium in Hyderabad from Chennai after the Tamil Nadu Cricket Association failed to acquire approval from the local government to reopen 3 stands at the M. Chinnaswamy Stadium. The closure of stands I, J and K with a combined capacity of 12,000 had robbed Chennai of matches during the 2016-2020 World Cup. The last time the stands has been opened was during the India-Australia Test match in 2013. While the Chennai Super Kings still have chance to play qualifier 1 at home if they finish among the top 2 teams in the league, but the eliminator and the qualifier 2 has been shifted to Visakhapatnam. Meanwhile, the first 3 team mini women's IPL will be held from May 6 to 10 in Jaipur, with a new team Velocity being added to the existing Trailblazer and Supernovas. Moving to our question number 7. In which article of the Indian Constitution the Panchayat is defined? The correct answer is option A, Article 243. Article 243 is the Constitution of India, defines the concept of Panchayat. India observes the National Panchayati Raj Diwas on 24th April every year. The Constitution of India recognizes Panchayats as institution of self-government. 24th April marks the passing of Constitution Act 1992 that came into force with effect from 24th April 1993. It permits states to take steps to organize village panchayats and provide them with necessary powers and authority necessary to facilitate them to function as units of self-government. The first National Panchayati Raj Day was celebrated in 2010. Now let me share a few more information about the 73rd Amendment 1992. The Constitution Act 1992 has vested constitutional status on Panchayati Raj institutions. The 73rd Amendment 1992 added a new Part 9 to the Constitution title, the Panchayats, covering provisions from Article 243 to 243O. And a new 11th schedule covering 29 subjects within the functions of the panchayats. Heading to our question number 8. Indian government extended ban on import of milk products from which country? The correct answer is option D, China. The government extended the ban on import of milk and milk products including chocolates, chocolate products, candies or confectionery, food preparations with milk or milk solids as an ingredient from China. The order follows two regulator FSSAI's recommendation that the ban should be extended till laboratories at ports are suitably upgraded for testing presence of toxic chemical melamine. Melamine is a toxic chemical used for making plastics and fertilizers. The ban was first imposed in September 2008 and extended subsequently from time to time. The latest ban imposed by the government ended April 23, 2019. Now let me share few more informations about India's milk production. India is the world's largest producer and consumer of milk. It produces around 150 million ton milk annually. Uttar Pradesh is the leading state in milk production, followed by Rajasthan and Gujarat. Moving to our question number 9. Ministry of Ayush signed MOU with Dash for cooperation in areas of traditional systems of medicine and its integration with modern science. The correct answer is option C, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. The Ministry of Ayush signed MOU with the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research for cooperation in research and education in areas of traditional system of medicine and its integration with modern science. The aim is to bring both Ministry of AYUSH and CSIR together to pursue focused R&D efforts in the domain. Under the MOU, both the organizations shall jointly endeavor to pursue R&D covering fundamental research, AYUSH specific diagnostic tools, exploring modern scientific methods for integration with traditional Indian systems of medicine, linking disease signature, furthering the collaboration in preserving and protecting traditional knowledge related to the Indian system of healthcare through the existing TKDL platform. The MOU also enables the facilities concepts such as traditional knowledge-inspired drug discovery and development and food as medicine. Now let me share few more informations about AYUSH. AYUSH, Ayurveda, Yoga and Naturotherapy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy is abbreviated as AYUSH. It is a governmental body in India purposed with developing education and research in the field of alternative medicines including Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Naturotherapy, Siddha and Homeopathy. It is headquartered at New Delhi. The minister responsible is Shripad Nayak. Heading to our question number 10. Which country released a special stamp on theme of Ramayana? The correct answer is option B, Indonesia. Indonesia released a special commemorative stamp on the theme of Ramayana to mark the 17th anniversary of the establishment of its diplomatic ties with India. It was designed by renowned Indonesian sculptor Padma Sri Bapang Nyoman Nyotra, featured a scene from Ramayana in which Jatayu valiantly fought to save Sita. A specially signed version of the stamp will be on display at Philately Museum in Jakarta. India's Ambassador Pradap Kumar Rawat and Indonesia's Vice Foreign Minister Abdul Rahman Muhammad Fajir attended the event. Now let me share few more informations about Indonesia. The President is Joko Widodo. The Vice President is Joseph Kalla. The capital is Jakarta. The currency is Indonesian Rupiah. To conclude this session, here comes the question of the day. Volcanoes that erupted in historical times but are now quiet is called dash. Try to answer the question and drop your answer in the comment box. Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find the information provided in our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated on current affairs. Dear friends, are you looking for a job? End your search now. Visit freshersly.com, the next generation of placement network. Register yourself today and get placed in top companies. Until then, this is Freshers Life signing out from Current Affairs video. Take care.